Hi, I'm Matt Bush, and you can draw Star Wars.
Welcome to Episode 5, Wash Painting. The book You Can Draw Star Wars shows you additional tools for painting with color. However, today, artist Matt Bush will show you his specific underpainting technique with washes.
Welcome back. In today's episode, we're going to begin the painting process with acrylic washes. What exactly is a wash anyway? A wash is basically watered down paint. You can use watercolors or create your own color washes to gouache or acrylics by just adding water to them. To hold my washes, I use old film canisters like this one right here. Now this is great because they've got an airtight cap. This will keep your paint from drying out. Next, I'm going to need acrylic paint. And I use it straight out of the tube like this one, but it comes in a variety of sizes and containers. I add a squeeze of paint to the canister, equivalent to the amount of toothpaste you'd put on your toothbrush. I then fill the rest with water. Using a paintbrush, I mix the paint and water into a consistent wash. I've got my yellow wash. We're ready to start this huge painting. Now, I've got the whole day set aside for this daunting project, and the way that I begin painting is the same way any artist would begin to work.
Yeah, no, the painting's coming out great. Colors look awesome. What am I doing right now? I'm working. Totally working.
I begin painting yellow around the sand troopers. Now, sand isn't yellow, but this is just the wash underpainting. I start with basic colors, and then I see where I need to go from there. Stormtroopers. They think they're so tough, don't they? I'm now using green to paint in the undertone of this Imperial officer, and blue to paint in the Tatooine sky. Many aspiring artists will ask me complex questions of how I choose specific colors, but honestly, with this technique, it's not that difficult. The book You Can Draw Star Wars shows several ways to use the color wheel and create color harmony in your painting. My process is to begin with the literal colors and steer them into harmony later. So, for example, these tough sand troopers are wearing orange shoulder pauldrons, so I just paint them orange. However, sometimes I'll have to make a color choice early on. To help separate Vader from the blue chasm of the Death Star, I decide to use purple. But again, this is just the underpainting, and a lot of this will be covered up later. At this point, I begin to render with my washes. Here I'm using a black wash to paint in the various panels of the Death Star. I'm also adding in layers to help smooth the Death Star's transition from light to shadow. Remember when we went over form shadow in Episode 2? For Grand Moff Tarkin, I'll use skin tones and darker browns to render out the shadows. We'll flesh out the planes of his face later. Here I am painting in the shadows and details of a Star Destroyer. The shadows are really what gives starships their form. Not only the overall shadows, but also the smaller shadows of all the cannons and compartments alongside and under the hull. There are three reasons why I choose to paint with acrylics. One, they dry fast. Two, they're the only non-toxic paint there is, which is nice. And three, acrylics are the most inexpensive paints you can buy. Hey, a penny saved is a penny earned, right? Man, what is it about all these stormtroopers?
Oh, I'm an elite soldier of the Imperial Army.
I'm using browns to paint in the shadows under the Banthas. To help make these Banthas and Tusken Raiders appear tattered in the sandy desert, I'm adding a yellow ochre wash entirely over them. Now it's time for the airbrush stage. Most of my work is hand-painted. However, sometimes on larger pieces, like this poster, I'll use an airbrush to fill in large areas of color. I'll also use an airbrush to soften gradations, like the form shadow here on the Death Star. The kind of airbrush that I use is gravity feeding. That means I just take my acrylic wash here, I pour it in the top there, and now we're ready to shoot paint. Pressing down on the trigger will release constant air. By pulling back on the trigger, you can adjust how much paint sprays out. I'm airbrushing some blue into the Tatooine sky to help smooth it out. The sky is always darker at the top and lighter as it gets closer to the horizon. Also, I'm purposely letting a little bit of the blue's overspray hit the stormtroopers. This'll help reflect the sky in their white armor, and how brave would these stormtroopers be without their armor? I'd love to meet a few of these guys and see how tough they really are. I'll spray in skin tones over Grand Moff Tarkin's face. I'm still using reference to help me with the values. I'll also go in with a darker brown to knock back the darker shadows. I'm now using white to fill in any glows. In the top half of the painting, there are many areas of the Death Star's chasm that has glowing lights. I'm painting in the glows now, but will paint in specific lights later. I'm also spraying glows around the twin suns of Tatooine. The whole idea of this stage is to get rid of the white board. We'll control our highlights later when we paint them in opaquely.
Ah, no!
In the next episode, provided Matt's still here and the Galactic Empire hasn't heard about him making fun of Imperial Stormtroopers, he'll show you the opaque part of his painting process.
So basically, this is the first half of the painting stage. The first thing that we're doing is trying to get rid of the white, we're trying to lay down all of our colors, and then what we're going to do next time is, hey guys, I was just kidding about what I said earlier. Seriously, hey, come on, I was kidding. Whoa, hey, come on.
Thanks for watching this re-release episode in higher quality. Please give me a like and let me know in the comments what kind of new episodes you'd like to see. Be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss a video. Thanks also for sharing this video and check out my other new videos in Matt's Class, Sketchbook Challenge, Hollywood is Dead, and Aladdin 3477. Keep drawing and, I don't know, fly casual.